going on, Sexy Family? I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day today. Got a smile on your face and you're ready for a brand new video. If you're not yet subscribed and a part of the family, what are you doing with your life? Make sure to smash that subscribe button, turn on post notifications to never miss out on a brand new video when I do happen to drop it here on my channel. Real quick, if you guys want to cop this hoodie, go to JeffSaxonVlogs.com. We also do have a brand new shirt now up on the store itself. Everyone needs a little sax in their life. This was actually a fan idea shirt. So thank you to that fan, guys. That shirt is now available on the website itself as well. Also, we do have the 100K subscriber t-shirt, which is very limited and will be gone by December 1st. So make sure to cop your merch at JeffSaxonVlogs.com. Anyways, today we're going to be having a bit of a story time, as you guys can tell by the title and thumbnail of this video, on how I thought I became a billionaire overnight at the age of 22. Yeah, I'm gonna link that video down below in the video description if you guys wanna go check it out. It's on storyfire.com, and also you can go download it on iOS and Android. The links for that will be down below in the video description. But before we do get into that story, I do wanna say, guys, make sure to follow me on all my social medias, including my Facebook page, everything at Jeff Saxon Vlogs. You guys can actually get early updates on videos before they even come out on all my social medias. Anyways, let's talk about how I thought I became a billionaire overnight back a few weeks ago when I was in Colorado. You see, a few weeks ago I went to Colorado to try to get my job back working for McJugger Nuggets, and guy played the lottery and he played a trick on me. So I was in the hotel room and he thought he won the Mega Millions or Billions and decided to pull a little prank-a-roo on Jeffrey here. Yeah, I just referred to myself in third person, don't judge. So he takes a look at his ticket, he starts freaking out, and he tells me to pick up the camera and just record for him at the moment. So I start recording and I'm like, wow, this guy just won the Mega Billions. I mean, like, I feel very happy for him. Like, I didn't know honestly how to feel at the time. Like, I was very happy for him. I was like, wow, like, congrats to you, that's insane. And then he decides to give me his winning ticket, and honestly, I didn't know what to say at that point, because emotionally I was like, holy, like, that right there is a lot of money. There's a lot of things I could personally do with that money. I can pay off my parents' debt. I can put my sister through college. I can make sure my brother, who has all this college debt, is paid off. Make sure, like I was saying, with my sister through college, put my stepsister through the rest of her college, make sure her debt's put through. Make sure, like, my niece and nephew, who I absolutely love, who are like my world, make sure college and everything in the future is paid for them. And honestly, donate money, do all these crazy things. So I ended up, you know, looking up the rules, because apparently he bought the ticket in California, and I was like, okay, well, if you bought it in California, I'm pretty sure you'd have to cash that ticket in California. You can't cash it in Colorado. So I started researching all the rules and regulations. I was like, oh, okay. Well, in California, you have to actually go there to claim the winning ticket. The first thing you gotta do is, though, make sure you sign your signature on the back of that piece of paper so nobody else can claim it. And then I started looking up the rules and regulations for the lottery in California, because that's where the ticket was quote-unquote bought. And I was like, oh, okay, so I have to fly to California to actually cash this thing in. So now I'm scrambling, trying to think, like, okay, I need to get a next flight either tonight or tomorrow, go to California, Texas, and I text my mom, hey, don't tell anybody, we may have won the Mega Millions. I was trying to figure out what I was going to do. Was I going to drive there? Was I going to fly there? Was I going to get the next flight as soon as possible to get to California? I ended up calling the California lottery a few different times saying, hey, I think I may have won the Mega Millions, aka the Mega Billions jackpot, and I was very, very excited to then find out the next day that it was all elaborate prank. And it kind of stinks, you know. I thought, like, my life was instantly changed right there, and I thought I was gonna be a billionaire, have racks on racks of money to be able to do things and help people and just do all these crazy things and even make the content for you guys 10 times better. But nope, your boy did not win the Mega Billions as thought. So the link to that video will be down below in the video description if you guys wanna go check it out on storyfire.com. But in the meantime, once again, I do wanna thank you guys so much for this silver play button right here. This thing absolutely means the world to me. If you guys did not see my last video, I actually dedicated this play button right here to my father. I went to the cemetery and, you know, his grave, and dedicated it to him. So thank you guys so much. I know a lot of people asking, well, who's that other guy in your video? That is my stepfather, Jim, who I do call dad. It took a few years personally for me to be able to do that, because, you know, when you're young and you lose your father, you're kind of like emotionally destroyed. So I'm able to finally call this man dad because he's done so much for me and my family, and I appreciate everything he's always done for us. Hopefully I could clear up some confusion with the questions I was being asked about that, but once again, just from the bottom of my heart, thank you guys so much for this play button. Hey, take a quick look at this. I actually now have a floor. If you guys notice, there's just been a bunch of stuff right there. For those that don't know, I practically live right here in the living room. My roommate has that room back there, but so my bed's right there, my desk is right there. This is basically my studio, I guess you could say apartment, because it's literally where I sleep right now is basically a studio. But all this cool stuff right here is just like, yeah, thank you guys. I gotta figure out how to hang this stuff correctly and like put, I don't really want to put holes in the wall, so I want to see if there's like anything I can actually put in the walls to keep these hanged up. So there's these little hooks or that little hook there, so I want to see if there's something that could hook that on. And then with the new play button too, there's like a thing right here, so maybe like a sticky hook for each one, and maybe the play button could be hung up on the wall. I honestly like have no clue about that just yet, what I'm gonna do, but the plan is putting it up over there very, very soon. And oh yeah, over here guys, you come over here, as you guys see, currently charging the good old Mavic drone, one of my favorite drones. I really love my Phantom 4, and I really love the Mavic. Each drone I have serves its own purpose, and this thing right here is another piece of equipment I actually love to use. I plan on actually using this very soon. It's a DJI Osmo, but it is currently DEAD, dead, because I lost the charger, which actually I gotta check my mailbox to see if the charger I ordered for that did come in today, because I wanna use that very soon. I wanna get into exploring some places again. I have a friend named Kyle McRan who does abandoned building stuff, along with my friend Jake Duffner. So it'll be kind of like a cool little trio going around exploring some places. Let me know if you guys would wanna see some exploration videos here on the channel. We go to abandoned places like abandoned mansions, abandoned prisons. I almost like forgot how to speak for a second. But yeah, I want you guys' input and opinion. Should we do some exploration videos here on the channel? Would you guys want them like 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, an hour long? I don't know. Let me know down below in the comment section, because I do value you guys' opinions and thoughts here on the channel. Speaking of that charging cable, I think it may have finally arrived actually in my mailbox. So let me just place my camera right here. Oh, yeah. Hey, is it gonna actually, no? Oh, hey, yeah, actually it is gonna stay. Just, it's giving me awful headroom right now, so I'm gonna stand here on my tippy toes while I find the correct key to put into the mailbox. And jury says, oh, wow, that was a good catch by me. But the jury says, nothing? Nothing, no dang package might be in the office. I guess I'm gonna have to go checking the apartment office and see if there is a package in there for me. And if there is, that's great. But also while I'm there anyway, I have to get a parking pass. My friend Jake Duffner is coming over to spend the night, so maybe I might record another video tonight with them. Well, I didn't ask for the package because they are closing right now and they already had all the doors locked up, but I was able to last second finesse a parking pass for my friend Jake. I didn't realize, I mean, it's like, I guess it is late, so it would make sense they're already closing. I just, you know, I'm on a different time schedule compared to like everybody else, like all the normal people out there. Like I used to get up every day at like 6:30 in the morning, 6:30 in the morning back when I used to work for the government. And then I'd go to bed maybe like 11 midnight. Like my sleep schedule is so messed up to where I don't even go to bed some nights till almost 5 a.m. and some days don't wake up till almost 3 p.m. So yeah, I guess you could say I am on a different schedule compared to basically everyone else here in the world. I do actually need all of your help with a video idea to get payback on my roommate for shaving my beard a few weeks ago as a prank. That video is here on my channel if you want to go check it out later. But yeah, as you guys see, the beard is finally growing back, thankfully. But I need to get her back, so I need some ideas from you guys to help me prank her and get her back. That's actually gonna wrap it up for the vlog today. If you guys did enjoy it, do me a favor, drop a like on this video down below. Hit that subscribe button with notifications turned on to never miss out on a brand new upload here on the channel. Make sure to follow all my social medias at Jeff Saxon Vlogs, the Facebook page, the Twitter page, the Instagram page. And before we close off the video today, let's do the channelship membership shout out of the day. It's gonna go to these two wonderful people right there who help support me and my channel by becoming channel members. The link to that will be down below in the video description. In return, I end up giving channel members a shout out here in the vlog. Also, let's do the Twitter shout out of the day. It's gonna go to this person right there who retweeted this video over on my Twitter at Jeff Saxon Vlogs. If you want the Twitter shout out of the day, all you gotta do is retweet this video over on my Twitter. Thank you all so much for watching today, guys. It's been your boy Jeff, keeping it real. I'm gonna log out. I'm gonna peace out and well. Peace.